no.
There you are, Citrine. I've been waiting.
Oh? Whatever for, Lapis?
I was hoping to join you for midnight training. It's sure to be more fun with a partner, right?
Oh my! But it would be terrible of me to deprive you of a full night's rest.
Please, I'm the terrible one. I still feel bad about the last time we talked. Besides, I can't sleep if I know a good friend is working through the night.
Lapis, you're so kind. I had something that I wanted to offer you as well. Here, take this.
A note? No, an address. What is this?
That's the mailing address for one of my family's spare manors in the heart of town. We haven't lived there in quite a while, so it's only staffed by grounds and housekeepers.
Okay, but why are you giving me the address?
If you wish to hide your rural origins, you must consider where your care packages come from. Think of this as your new forwarding service. If your parents send their packages there, the staff will swap addresses and route them here. Why, your family could even use that address as a vacation home, or they could just move in. The manor is theirs to use as they like.
Wow, Citrine, thank you. I didn't realize how much you cared.
Think nothing of it. I'm just looking out for one of my dearest friends.
It's a wonderful offer, but I can't accept it.
What? Why not?
My family isn't noble, but I'm proud of them. I can't ask them to hide where they're from. I'm still nervous about other people finding out, but at least I won't have to worry around you.
Oh my, we are quite the pair, aren't we? Each of us has what the other lacks.
And we both reach out when the other needs help.
Not a bad working relationship.
Not bad at all. Do you think Prince Alchrist had this balance in mind when he selected us as his retainers?
Oh, I doubt it. I know you're enamored with him, but Alchrist isn't that clever.
What? I am not!
Goodness, you're blushing! Your cheeks are as red as the carpets in the royal court.
Come on, don't tease me.
Besides, those carpets aren't that red. You should see the tomatoes they grow back home.
Oh? That sounds like a fun day trip. Would you show me around sometime?
Sure, but don't bring any money. The farmers back home prefer to use a barter system.
How rustic. I've always wanted to try bartering. I could stand apart with a few necklaces.
Careful. With goods like that, you'll end up needing that spare manor for tomato storage.
Vael gave the Ring of the Holy Knight to the Divine Dragon.
Apologies, my lord.
The Ring of Azure Twins lost as well. Twice my four hounds failed me. You do understand the gravity of all this?
Yes.
And Vael?
Still in a deep slumber. No matter how much I amplify her draconic impulses, she won't awaken.
She refuses her true nature. In that case, take this.
What is it?
An enchanted helmet. It will strengthen the spell you cast on her. My power with your spell will correct what is wrong with Vale.
I see.
Keep it safe. Use it when the time is right.
Of course. As you will it. There is something else I would like to discuss.
What?
Pardon me, Lord Sombron, but Lady Vale is your only child, correct?
My only living child?
Yes.
That is correct.
Of course. I was speaking from fear, not fact. Forgive me.
Why ask such a thing?
Vale believes one of her siblings is alive. I thought it best to raise with you. She spoke of an unbroken Drakenstone. But she must be mistaken. We both know the truth. Your children were killed in the war 1,000 years ago, all but Vale. I remember one who stood above the rest, with hair and eyes like fire. What was the name again? Something like...
Zephyr.
My lord.
I do not remember all my children's names or faces. But that one I killed myself.
Yes.
Moments later, I was imprisoned. Did you collect the body?
I did not.
Then I rescind what I said. The answer is no. And if you find that offspring, bring me a corpse this time.
Yes, Lord Sombron. As you wish.
Thanks for arranging this ship for us, Alfred.
Thank my mother, not me. When I said we were headed to Illusia, she got one of the fleet's finest lined up.
How was everything at the capital?
Well enough. There haven't been any attacks since we left for Brodia.
What a relief.
I told Mother what the other side's been up to, how they're after Sovereign Blood. She was shocked, of course, to hear about King Morian and King Hyacinth.
Understandably so.
As for the destruction at Floraport, the royal family will spare no expense on aid, though it may be years before the harbor is returned to its original beauty.
We must defeat the Fell Dragon so that such horrors never happen again.
What's our plan? When we arrive, do we head straight for Illusia Castle?
First, we should try to learn what we can from the Illusian people. Rings or no rings, if we don't know what we're up against, we could lose everything. Besides, there's something I need to find out.
And what's that?
Whether Vale is all right.
From our vantage, the Hounds certainly didn't seem pleased.
They may attempt to erase her personality. If anyone can do it, that woman can.
I know Vale killed my mother. Nothing we've learned changes that, but I can't help but worry about her. I hope she's not hurt.
Yes, I suppose she's a victim in this too. And she did risk her neck to give us the ring.
Or it was all an act and she's just gaining our trust to stab us in the back. Again.
That's worth considering. We don't know enough to rule anything out.
Still, I want to trust her.
Divine One, excuse me. Two ships flying Illusian colors approach from ahead.
Any sign of the Hounds?
None. However, it appears the enemy intends to attack us.
Then we've got no choice but to fight them on the water. Prepare for battle, everyone!
We're fighting on two fronts. Good news is, the ship's got flame cannons that'll set fires and slow down the enemy. Be careful, though. Wouldn't want our allies to get caught in the blaze.
Since the king's death, my country has become something unrecognizable. Illusia's armies serve Illusia no longer, but the Hounds. Is this truly what I meant to do?
I've got this.
Let's do this! How do I look?
Say the word. Do it.
No mistakes. Grant me strength. Watch this!
Let me at him!
Very well.
For peace.
Whatever you need.
With pride. Yes?
They're nice and distracted. Don't mind me, chumps. I'm just here for the treasure.
Here we go!
Emblem, engage!
Allow me!
I've had my eye on you. It's over.
Thank you.
Unbelievable. This is so embarrassing. I'm gonna pull out and get back to my training.
Perfection.
Here we go!
I'll go first.
I'm not a child anymore.
my friends.
Am I so unreliable?
I won, my princess.
Kill for me.
A good wind.
Ha 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 ha!
More fighting? Emblem, engage! If this is war, so be it. I still have a lot to learn. Ready. I will help. Tenacious! A thousand curses upon our enemy.
I will not forget your loss.
Death does not frighten me. I know my wife awaits me on the other side.
Guess I did it right.
Yeah.
It's over.
Better to act than to worry.
You aren't fighting?
I suppose I should. Yet I find myself reluctant to spill blood for this broken nation. Look at me, saying such a thing to my foe. I must be going senile.
Why don't you join me? I'm the Divine Dragon. My army is working to defeat the Fel Dragon and take back Illusia.
The Divine Dragon?
I know you're devoted to the Fel Dragon, but I am allied with Princess Ivy, if that helps.
Princess Ivy is alive. As far as I'm concerned, where she stands, there lies Illusia. My devotion has always been to the royal family itself. Please, take me with you.
Of course. Thank you.
Linden, long ago, I served as a royal soldier. I may be getting on in years, but with my magic, I can still open these soldiers' eyes to the truth. Your orders?
I won't fall!
Ready for me?
Why do we repeat our mistakes? Anytime.
You
Me first! A little rough here.
Dream well.
Made quick work of that.
Ready for anything. You were beautiful while you lasted. You're my hero!
Are you taking notes?
I'll help.
Ah!
Very well.
Whatever you ask.
I'll do as you command.
fight again!
I have my orders. You will not survive this battle.
You mustn't!
Here we go! I'll go first. Lend me your strength. I challenge my fate!
Ha! I'll begin!
You're annoying!
Me too!
You betrayed us!
I fight to restore Illusia. You fight for its decline. Which of us is truly on the wrong side?
Here!
Not over yet! I deserve no less.
Thanks!
If I may...
Thank you! Ah.
Illusia is in sight.
So, I've returned.
Are you all right?
Whatever has become of Illusia, I'll still do what I must. Givreport is a little farther north. I suggest sailing there.
Understood.
It's near the castle and the cathedral, so we should be able to gather intel there. I will inform the others of our destination.
Marth, Celica, Micaiah, Roy. We've returned without you, but we'll get you back this time. Just hang on.
Illusia. A return then to the land where we were separated from our fellow emblems.
If reunited, we can at last grant the power we offer once every 1,000 years.
We should discuss our other option. That is, the far greater power only we know about.
Yes, of course, the miracle. We could use that power at long last. I would suggest Lumera.
I don't like this idea. We shouldn't perform the miracle. We have to think of the future.
I agree. The whole future. We can't favor anyone with it now.
Favor someone? We're talking about Lumera. We can prevent a tragedy.
Please, those of us who were scattered in other lands are still learning all that's happened.
Some of us were at her castle. Some were not.
It's natural to see things differently. So, we are not all in agreement. At least at present.
Using our power every 1,000 years is one thing. The miracle, we've never used it before. Never in all of existence.
The cost of doing so is not small. Perhaps we should never, ever use it. Of course, we are not all here. What might the others think? What might they decide?
What in blazes? This here.
Oh, wow!
Yunaka, do you have a moment?
Sure.
About that sparring match just now. I feel like your attitude needs adjusting.
What do you mean?
A sparring match isn't a fight to the death, but you went right for my throat back there. I'd like it if you slowed things down a bit. Try being a bit more sporting.
What? No, sorry, but that's ridiculous. I'm not gonna do that.
Excuse me?
Marin, I know you think it's super stylish to pause for a monologue in the middle of a fight, but if you're gonna do that, you might as well point to your kidneys and ask for a shanking. With me, the worst you get is a bump on the noggin. A real enemy would eviscerate you.
I know that. I just wanted to test out a bit of verbal repartee.
Test it for what? If it's no good in an actual engagement, then what good is it?
I get it, I do. But what's wrong with a bit of verbal jousting during sparring matches? Dropping a catchphrase during combat spices things up. A mid-battle monologue sounds cool. Just do what you need to do after I'm done talking. We're allies, after all.
No. It's a bad habit to make light of combat. I thought for sure you'd understand that, seeing as you're a knight. Guess I was mistaken. If that's all, I'll be going.
Come on, Yunaka. You're right, of course. I just wanted to have a bit of fun.
You know what'd make a nice picture? You and a dashing prince. Or maybe an obedient butler.
Chloe, if we're gonna be fighting side by side, I think maybe you should be the one next to me.
I often wonder why war is so commonplace. Why are people so keen to hurt each other?
I couldn't agree more. It should be a crime to force anyone as charming as us to fight.
Lovely profile.
Ah.
Thank you.
Let's make it cute. Presentation is important. Tastes as good as it looks.
Whoa!
Oh.
I packed a meal for you.
Pardon me. I'm reluctant to enter like this. But this is my duty. Divine One. Divine One? Good morning. It's just me today. Is this wake-up call too formal for you? My apologies.